Today we'll tell solution of a problem on composites, and this problem is taken from a textbook on advanced mechanics of solids by Srinath. The question is like this: a glass fiber reinforced nylon composite contains E glass fibers 30% by volume. Determine percentage of load carried by the glass fibers when the composite is loaded along its longitudinal direction. The Young's modulus of glass fiber and nylon is given. For glass fiber, it is 72 gigapascal, and for nylon, it is 2.8 gigapascal. So the volume fraction is given 0.3. Young's modulus for matrix and fiber is given. So the nylon is matrix, and the E glass as the fiber, and the Young's modulus for fiber and matrix is 72 gigapascal and 2.8 gigapascal respectively. The volume fraction of fiber is 0.3. So the volume fraction of matrix will be 1 minus 0.3, which is 0.7. The question is to calculate percentage of load carried by the fibers when the composite is loaded, or mathematically we can write it as load taken by PF, load taken by fiber, that is PF divided by P is equal to how much. So what you can do, we can frame one equation first from the load. So load taken by the composite P is equal to P matrix plus P fiber, because whatever the total load, that will be taken by matrix and fiber. That is equation number one. PM plus PF is equal to P. That is equation number one. Then we know strain is equal to stress by Young's modulus. Strain in matrix is sigma M by EM, and strain in fiber is sigma F by EF. But for composites, to find out the load, there is an assumption. The strain in matrix and fiber will be same. Whenever you are applying load along the longitudinal direction, then the assumption is epsilon M is equal to epsilon F. If you substitute values, it is sigma M by EM is equal to sigma F by EF. Then if you bring that sigma F from right hand side to the left hand side, it will become sigma F by sigma F is equal to EM by EF. Now put the values of EM and EF. 2.8 divided by 72, which is 0.0388. So sigma matrix is equal to 0.0388 into sigma F. Leave it as equation number 2. Now we have to find out PF by P is equal to how much. So PF divided by P. P can be written as again PF plus PM. And now we can replace the load into stress. So PF can be written as sigma F into AF. And PM can be written as sigma M into EM. So the numerator is sigma F into AF divided by denominator is sigma M into AM plus sigma F into AF. If we'll divide area of the composite on the numerator and denominator, AF by SE will become VF. Similarly, AM by SE will become VM. AF by SE is VF. So the equation will become like this: sigma F into VF divided by sigma M into VM plus sigma F into VF. Now we know VF and VM, so substitute here sigma F into 0.3 divided by sigma M. From equation number 2, we know it is 0.0388 into sigma F. Then VM is equal to 0.7 plus sigma F into 0.3. Now numerator is sigma F into 0.3 divided by denominator sigma F, you take it as common, and the remaining thing if you operate calculator is 0.3272. Sigma F will get cancelled. So 0.3 divided by 0.3272 will be 0.9168. That means PF by P is equal to 0.9168, or that can be written as 91.68%. So the percentage of load that is carried by the fibers out of the total load is 91.68%. And the other load will be taken by the matrix.